Welcome to week three of our series, Go. Today's big idea is God will protect my heart and mind. Our Bible verse for the day is Philippians chapter 4, verses 4 through 9 and 13.
So, how many of you like superheroes? Maybe you like superhero movies or superhero comics. Maybe you have superhero pajamas. Well, today we're going to play a really fun game, and it's called Backwards Superhero. Now, how it's going to work is I'm going to put up a superhero name on the next screen, and you are going to try and tell me or write down what superhero it is. So it's just going to be backwards, and time yourself and see how quickly you can guess which superhero it is. And now it's time for our video lesson.
Hi there, little chicken nuggets. It's me, Carl. Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV. Introducing your host, Carl. And your co-host, Cassie. Where we learn, where we grow, and we talk about Jesus. Once again, welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome, kiddos. Hope you're having a wonderful day. I've recently gotten some letters from you, little chicken nuggets. I'm gonna take some time to answer some questions. It's mail time. Alrighty, letter number one. Matt asks, hey Carl, how long can you hold your breath? Well, let's find out. Okay, well that didn't go as planned. And now my head hurts. Number two. Samantha asks, hey Carl, if you could be any animal in the world, what animal would you want to be? Well, Samantha, I've always wanted to be a flamingo, or a gorilla, a wildebeest, a North African crane, red sparrow, Mongolian honey badger, horseshoe crab. But obviously, if I had to choose one, it'd probably be a house cat. Meow. Last but not least, letter number three. I have a feeling this is gonna be a good one. Alex says, dear Carl, your face stinks.
Hey Carl, how you doing?
Not so good. I don't want to talk about it.
Carl, it's okay. You can tell me. What happened?
Well, I was sitting there, opening up fan mail. And someone said something that really got me sad.
Oh, that's terrible. What did it say?
I don't know if I could talk about it.
Okay, can you act it out?
Okay.
Your face? Your face stinks?
Yes. Yes!
Oh, wow, that's really mean. I bet they were just kidding. Your face doesn't really stink. By the way, why are you wearing so many sweaters?
Because I'm protecting my heart.
Your heart?
Yes. That main letter made my heart hurt, so I'm wearing all these vests for extra protection.
Carl, I'm not sure it works that way.
Sure it does. Try and hurt me.
I really don't want to do that.
Come on. I want you to.
No, I really...
Do it!
No.
Do it!
Fine.
Oh!
Carl, I'm sorry, but I do think you can learn from this.
How?
Well, in Philippians, it says God will guard our hearts and our minds.
Really?
Really. God loves you so much, Carl. He promises to protect our minds, and especially our hearts, even though they might hurt sometimes.
Wow, that's really good news.
It is, and God means it. So how do you feel now?
I mean, better. It still hurts. but I am starting to get sweaty, so.
I bet.
Say, how do you know about that verse?
God says to keep his words on our hearts. So to remember God's words, I must read them. So every day, I try to read the Bible.
You do it every day?
I try. Sometimes I forget, but that's okay, as long as I keep trying.
That's good to know.
Yep, and when we get to know God better through the Bible, the more we can trust he's gonna protect our hearts and our minds.
So God will protect our hearts and mind? Whoa, that's our big idea. Today's big idea is this. God will protect our hearts and our mind. So let's all say it together on three. One, two, three. God will protect our hearts and our mind. Well, good job, guys. Good job, Cassie.
Thanks, Carl.
Oh.
This week, we're looking at what do we do when life gets hard? I don't know about you, but in this season of being home and so many things being uncertain, it's hard to be positive. It's hard even to know how to feel majority of the time. This week, let's look and see what Paul has to say about how we're to be even in difficult circumstances. It can be hard, but let's see what happens. This is from Philippians, which is toward the back of your Bible, chapter 4, the big number 4, and the little starting in verse 11. I am not saying this because I am in need, for I have learned to be content whatever the circumstances. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all things through him who gives me strength. Now, sometimes we look at that and think, oh, it just means we have to be happy all the time, or force ourselves to think that, oh, it's not that big of a deal. When in reality, when our life feels difficult, that's the truth. This time and season has been difficult. What Paul's talking about here is not just putting a smile on and saying, don't worry, be happy. What he's talking about here, when he says to be content in all things, he's referring to still trusting that God is in charge and that God is who he says he is. It's not pretending that everything is perfect or that we're not sad or angry or frustrated about what's going on. What he's talking about here is we can feel all of those emotions and also be content that we know and that we're trusting that God is who God is, that he is faithful, that he is taking care of us, and he is who he says he is.
Using this printout, or a drawing of your own, it's time for you to create your own superhero and decide what powers they would have.
And now it's time to hear our memory verse for the month. Try and sing along with Jason to Matthew 5:16.
All right, this morning, we're gonna try to do something a little different. We're gonna sing this song three times through, but each time we're gonna try a different voice. So we'll start off with our regular voices. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. Matthew 5:16. Matthew 5:16. All right, this time we're going to do monster voices. Get ready. In the same way, let your light shine before others. They may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. Matthew 5:16. All right, take your teeth out. We're gonna start toothless.
In In the same way lived our lives and before brothers. That they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. Matthew 5:16.
Great job!
Thanks so much for joining us this week. Let's spend some time praying and asking God to help us be honest about how we feel, but also trust Him that He is who He says He is. We also want to let you know that if you're feeling a lot of big emotions and don't know what to do with that, to talk to an adult, talk to your parents, talk to a grandparent, an aunt and uncle, and share how you feel. People around you love you and want to support you. But now we're going to spend a little time asking God to help us trust Him. And we look forward to seeing you next week.